Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you are new. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button, and let's get right into today's video. So today I have a gel polish set from Model Ones. Model Ones was kind enough to send over this 36 color gel polish nail set for me to try out. So thank you so much to Model Ones for sending over this gel polish set. I am super excited to try out these gel polishes and just look at all of the colors. Here is the back of the box in case you are interested. You may pause to read. So opening up this box does include so many different gel polishes. I was amazed when opening this box up. I was just so stunned with all of the colors and also like the gold and silver caps on like the top and base coat. But here are all of the colors. This set does include a matte top coat, a regular top coat, a base coat, and the set also includes a nail primer. All of these are 7ml bottles, including the 36 colors of gel polishes. This is really just a pamphlet. It is so huge because it has all different languages on it, which is great. It doesn't have any pictures, but gel polishes are very easy to use and understand. So here is just an overlook at all of the color stickers on tops of the bottles. I was amazed with all of these colors, and I really love Model One's gel polish. And thank you again to Model One's for sending over this gel polish set. So because this gel polish set does include 36 different colors, I did decide that I was going to be swatching them off camera. So here are all of the swatches. I will be showing them in individual sections, but I felt like swatching them on camera would just take a little bit of time. And also, I thought it may be a little bit boring. I don't know if you guys do like to watch swatching. Maybe you do, but I am sorry, but I just decided to swatch these off camera. These are all only one coat of each of the colors, and I was just amazed with all of the colors in this set. There are just so many beautiful colors, and it also includes some glitter shades, and they are all so gorgeous. The nail set I first had in mind while I was swatching these gel polishes was going to be like a mix and match French tip set, but I did decide that these colors did not fit what I wanted to do. These colors are a little bit more neutral shades, not neutral shades, but like neutral colors, and I just felt like the mix match French tips were more of bright and popping out colors, and maybe this set was just not the right set for those colors. But overall, I thought all of these colors were greatly pigmented and very saturated. All of these swatches did only have one coat, and I thought they were all great with one coat. Also, I like to do my swatches in one coat just because that way I can see how saturated, I don't know why I cannot say that word, but how saturated, yep, I can't say it, how saturated the gel polishes are. Now let's move right into the nail set. For this nail set, I am going to be recreating a nail set from Nails by Key. Here is the picture that I'm going to be trying to recreate, and these are the colors of gel polish that I decided to use in today's set. I went ahead, sized out my full cover XXL square nail tips, and placed them on my nail stand, and I'm just going to show these colors, and then we will move right into the nail set. I wanted to mention that if you have not checked out Nails by Key channel, she is a truly great person and I love all of her nail sets. She gives me so much inspiration all of the time and I was just so happy recreating one of her nail sets. I didn't exactly recreate it, like do the same exact thing as her, but I did really get my inspiration for this nail set from her, and she is just the greatest person and I totally recommend checking out her channel. She does a lot of nail videos and she is truly an awesome person. So now let's go ahead and move into the nail set. I already sized out my nail tips and I'm going to be starting off with my thumb and ring finger. I do have those flipped upside down on the nail stand just because I thought I was doing a French tip on these, and I thought that I would place my nude color on the inside of the nail to help, like, stop the bulkiness. I don't know if you guys understand what I mean by that, but when I'm doing French tips, I seem to get, like, a little bit of bulkiness from the French tip, and I feel like placing the nude or the full nail cover on the inside of the nail tip really helps with that bulkiness. So I'm just applying one coat to both of these nails and curing in my nail lamp for 60 seconds. While the two nude nails were curing, I decided that I would move on to my index and pinky, which were going to be marbling. And I'm using these four colors. They are three different shades of brown and then one glitter. I absolutely love how these marbled nails turned out, and it was a very easy way to do marble. I've seen marble done like you place your colors on like a tray and then scoop it up with a different brush and lay it on the nail, but the way I did the marbling for this nail set was so much easier. Like, it was super easy to do, and I felt like it also helped to not have that bulkiness. At first, I don't know what I was doing here or what I was thinking. Like, I didn't even have my base color down, so I was like, what? And then I did place this darker brown as my base color, and I just placed that on the entire nail, and then without curing, I took the other colors and dotted them in, and then I just used a nail art brush and kind of swirled it in and created the marble effect I liked. And also, I just went back in with colors that I felt like needed a little bit more. Like the lighter browns, I felt like it just needed a little bit more of the lighter brown. That way you could really tell that it was a marble and not just a blob of colors. I really am glad that I added this glitter in, because this glitter polish just matched so well and it looked so cute having a pop of glitter throughout the marble. After I had all of the color on, I'm just going to be taking my nail art brush and blending in the color. Not really blending it, I kind of just act like I was scribbling, and just took my brush and moved the color around to where I wanted it. And after doing this, then you can tell what color you need more of. And obviously mine was that lighter brown. I just wanted to have more lighter brown mixed in the marble. And I just took that brush, added some more brown where I thought it was needed, and then took my nail art brush again and swirled that around. This was super easy, and I will definitely be doing more marbles in the future. I just love how marble nails turn out. And this one, obviously I'm doing a chocolate set, but I thought this nail just looked like a bowl of chocolate swirl ice cream. It just looked so yummy, this nail. I was just so obsessed with it. After I had the marbling like how I liked it, I went ahead and cured this for 60 seconds in my nail lamp, and this nail was good to go. And I was just going to be repeating that same exact thing on my index finger, using those same four colors, creating that same marble look, and then curing for 60 seconds in my nail lamp. Now moving on to my middle finger, I do have it on the wrong spot there, but this is actually my middle finger. I'm going to be taking the middle brown color and just applying that to the entire nail. And I was seeing if it would look good. It did look good in the end, but I'm just going to take this, apply it to the whole nail, and then I'm going to pop it in the lamp to cure for 60 seconds. After that was all cured, I'm now going to be taking the Model 1's matte top coat, applying that, and then I'm curing for 30 seconds in the nail lamp. Here is the nail after it is all matte, and for this nail, I'm going to be drawing on the sweater design. I thought making this a chocolate little sweater design, even though it wasn't chocolate, it was a sweater, but it was in brown, so it matched with the set still. I didn't know to begin with if I thought this would look good because I was making a chocolate nail set, of course. But in the end, I thought this really turned out super cute, and I loved the little sweater design. I thought this looked so cute in brown. Like, I was obsessed with this nail, probably one of my favorites, especially after I added the little charm. Stay tuned for the little charm I added. It made the nail look super cute. It was so adorable. But I'm just taking my Makart line brush and creating my sweater design. And I'm just creating two lines down the center of the nail, and then on each side of the lines I'm adding dots, and then in the center I'm just adding some more lines with like a diagonal line, creating like a sweater pattern. You really can do anything. You can look up on Pinterest or look on Instagram for inspo on sweater designs, and there are so many different sweater designs, but I just felt like this one was super easy and very minimal and still super cute, so I went ahead and did this sweater design. After I had the sweater design all drawn out, I did not cure, and now I'm taking my Model 1's clear acrylic powder, and I just purchased this. I love it. And I don't do acrylic, you guys know that. I am a polygel and gel girl, but I had to buy this acrylic because I obviously need it for my sweater designs, but yeah, now all you want to do is do not cure that gel polish, keep it uncured, and then you're just going to pour over the clear acrylic, and once you have poured and covered that entire nail, you just cure in your nail lamp for 60 seconds. After you did a full cure of 60 seconds, you're just going to take a dust brush and wipe away any of that excess acrylic powder. And here is how the nail looked. I was totally obsessed with this nail. I thought it looked so cute, and I love the way it looked with the matte base and then obviously the sweater design. It was a little hard to see, but it was so cute, and I thought it went so well with the nail set. So now I'm going to be going back to the marble nails, and I'm going to be taking that Model 1's base coat. That way we can get a sticky tacky layer to the surface of these nails. And I'm just quickly going to apply the base coat to both of these nails and cure in my nail lamp for 30 seconds. And then we are going to be adding some gold foils to these nails. Thank you. the base coat is curing on those marbled nails, I'm now going to be drawing on my French tips on the two nude nails. And this was very easy. I'm just taking my McCart line brush and the darkest brown, I think. Yeah, I use the darkest brown from the browns, and I'm just quickly creating a French tip. I found myself that since I've been doing French tips a little bit more often now, that I have been really getting better at them. I'm not perfect at them, but I really have seen improvement with my French tips from when I first started doing French tips. It would take me like an hour to just do one French tip when I first started. I'm not even lying. I would like be cleaning up. I'd be cleaning up so much where I would mess up the French tip, and it was just so bad. But I am so happy that I am now improving and can really do French tips and want to do French tips now because I'm a lot better at them. So I just drew my French tip line, and then I'm taking that gel polish and just filling it in. And I obviously had to add some glitter to these nails. I was trying to decide what glitter I wanted to use because I was looking at the McCart. Swiss Hot Chocolate may be the name for this decoration set. I'm not 100% sure. But I was looking at the glitters in there, and I was deciding if I wanted to use one of those or just like a brown glitter that I had. And the glitters in this set, they looked a lot more brown on camera, let me tell you. But in person, not a single one of these looked to have a speck of brown glitter. Like, I was surprised. Like, see, on camera, that looks brown, but in person, it did not have any brown glitter at all. Like, maybe I was blind for a second and couldn't see the brown glitter, but when I was looking at these, I could not see any brown glitter in them. So I decided that not to use any of those glitters, and I would just use one of the brown glitters that I had. And this is the brown glitter that I ended up using. So I'm just gonna be taking my dip powder recycler and holding that French tip nail over top of that and applying the glitter to that not cured French tip, and then I'm going to be curing for 60 seconds in my nail lamp. After I was finished with that thumbnail, I'm now just going to be repeating that same exact thing on my ring finger, drawing out the French tip with my line brush in that darkest brown, and then filling it in with the gel polish brush, and then before curing, applying the glitter, and then curing in my nail lamp for 60 seconds. Now I am finally coming back to the marbled nails, and I am going to be adding on some gold foil. Because I applied that base coat, I did not wipe off the sticky tacky layer that helps adhere the gold foils. These gold foils, any foils like this, are very clingy and hard to work with, I feel, but they just look so good in a nail set. So I am using two different pairs of tweezers because, like I said, I have troubles working with this foil, but I really think it just looks so good. So I'm just taking my tweezers, ripping off small pieces, and sticking it into that base coat. And I went ahead and repeated that with both of these nails because I just thought the lines of gold foil on this just made these nails look so good. I really loved that so much, and I just repeated that on both of the nails. And here are how all of the nails are looking. I absolutely love them. They were turning out so cute. So now I'm just going to be taking that Model 1's top coat and applying that to both of the marbled nails to seal in that gold foil. And then I'm going to be curing for 30 seconds in my nail lamp. After the top coat was all cured, here is how the final nail set is looking. Just kidding, I need to add some charms to this nail set. So here are how the nails look. You could just wear them like this, but I am obsessed with nail charms, so I had to add some nail charms. And I added this super cute little pink gold little bear on that sweater nail. I just thought it matched so perfectly. It wasn't really chocolate themed, and maybe this nail didn't go the best with this nail set, but I thought it was really cute, so I just couldn't resist. So I'm using my McCart rhinestone glue, placing some of that on the back of the bear, and then once I like the placement of that on the nail, I'm just going to cure in my nail lamp for 60 seconds. And now I pulled out these two charms. I did not end up using this donut charm, but I did end up using that little bag of, I don't know, I'm assuming it's like a little bag of candy that says sweet on it. I felt like the donut charm would overdo it, so I didn't use that donut charm, but I did use the little sweet bag charm. So I'm just applying some rhinestone glue to the back of that, placing it on the nail. Once I like the placement, I'm curing for 60 seconds. And here is the final nail set. Now I'm just going to be applying these to my natural nails using some McCart nail glue, and here are how they are looking. I'm just going to apply my cuticle oil and rub that in so I can nourish my cuticles. I really loved creating these nails. I had so much fun doing it. I loved doing the marbles, the sweater nails, and the French tips, also applying the charms. I just had so much fun creating this set and using these new gel polishes from Model 1's. Thank you again to Model 1's for sending me these gel polishes. I absolutely love them and totally recommend them to any nail lover. I will have them linked down below along with all of the other products that I used in today's video. have some very special surprises coming up, including a New Year's nail set. I am super excited to show you guys, so make sure you subscribe if you haven't already, and also turn on post notifications so you are notified when I do upload my videos. And if you did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up so that I know that you enjoyed. But I really did have a lot of fun creating these press-ons, and I think they turned out so freaking cute. Like, I just love these so much, and I feel like if I wouldn't have had this gel polish set with all of these different colors, including like the gorgeous brown shades, I would have never created a nail set like this. Also, if I wouldn't have had the inspiration from Nails by Key, because she really was the inspiration to this whole entire nail set. But there was just so many gorgeous colors in this gel polish set, and I just really loved them and totally loved how the nails turned out. I really hope that you guys enjoyed watching me create this nail set, and as always, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.